Why is she saying that you're unhappy looking at yourself?
Because the first pass is always tough for me.
I do,
but just the trouble is the first time I see anything I'm in, it's like, oh, well, wow, this is a great movie. Wow, I'm really enjoying the story here. What the hell am I doing? Why am I there? It yanks me out of it. And I'm thinking about, wow, that tie doesn't work, and, well, the hair looks stupid, and, you know, I just pick myself apart, and I get in my own way.
Yes.
I can't see me as the character yet. It takes a few viewings.
But if your director likes it, you've got to be happy with
it. That's what it's all about.
Exactly.
That's what it's all about, you know, because I made Clint tell me on several occasions, because he only does, like, you know, that's fine, we're moving on. You know, and you thought it was rehearsal, you know, and he wants to go on. So, I always make sure, are you happy? Are you happy? He goes, yeah, that was great. Okay, all right.
You do a good Clint.
Thank you very much.
What does he like to work with as an actor to actor?
Even when he's off camera, those eyes are boring holes into your skull, and it's, you know, you're getting there's a full performance happening next to the camera. He's not even there,
yeah.
And he's there. He's there for you. He's like, he's doing the full character, the full voice. You know, he's not just kind of rattling off the line. You know, he's giving you everything.
Is that common?
No.
Really?
No, it's not common enough. Sometimes you're talking to a tennis ball. Sometimes you're talking to a script supervisor who's reading the lines while the person you're supposed to be with is off getting their massage. I have no idea. But, it was that way with Tom Hanks and Catch Me If You Can. It was that way with Clint on this movie, just giving you everything, really feeding you. It was great. It's important, and it's really generous, and it's great.
So you do that, then, when you're called?
All the time. Oh, yeah. It's a lesson learned. Because if I'm with this A-lister awesome actor and they're doing it, then it's not too much for me to do.
So what's the appeal of Gran Torino?
The appeal of Gran Torino. I think people are going to love the initial political incorrectness of his attitude. And then it will. Well, it'll make you uncomfortable, but you'll laugh at the same time because you're laughing at him, you know. But it's also tapping into something in you that you realize is there because we're all human.
Yeah.
And I think what the great thing the movie does is that it brings him out of himself and his own opinions, and he has to address the needs of the people around him, and they suddenly become people. They're not them anymore. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and I think it's going to send a great message that way.
And we need that.
Yes. Amen.